Hi, doggy.
What are you doing, white man? What are you doing with the suitcase? You're packing to leave? You're leaving home? My doggy's leaving home. Wait, why? Why are you leaving home? Why are you leaving home? Three dogs in one house is enough? Three dogs? Where do you get three dogs? It's only you and Black Tooth. What about this show? Well, if you want to look at it that way, it's four dogs. Yeah, you forgot this studio. You're taking your rubber ducky and your bone? I remember that mailman. Your nightgown? You really going? Yeah? Where are you going? You don't know some small town? Somewhere away from the big city? But how will you live? You'll get a job? Well, listen, it's not easy for a dog to get a job in a small town. I got a job in Huntington? I mean a real dog. Well, listen, if you're really serious, you know, maybe I can help you. Well, see, I have an uncle lives in this small town, and they're looking for a dog to work in the fire department. See, it's a very small town, and the entire fire department is just a cart and a hose cart in a dog. Will your job be to pull the cart? No, you're to be there helping find the hydrant. I'm gonna tell my mom on you. Welcome once again to the show. Don't kiss. That's the biggest and sweetest dog in the United States, Black Tooth. Oh, Black Tooth, you old sweet dog, you. Where I was looking for you. Where you been? You went to the doctor? What kind of doctor? You went to the bone doctor? The bone doctor? Why'd you go to the bone doctor? See if he'd fix that so they'd come up seven every time? Please don't kiss. It's not healthy. You'll get used to it. All right, let's go to the words of wisdom. They're very important, and we want you to pay close attention to them, and they go like this. You show me a man who puts his parakeet in a blender, and I'll show you a man who makes shredded tweed. Now, what do we mean by that? No wonder you've been screaming on pins. This place is filled with cuckoos. Okay, now, I mean, be nicer to your feathered friends. Don't be a chirpscape and just give them chicken feed. Tweet them right, and they'll sing their tails off for you. Are we still on? I know a couple of lovebirds who just got encaged. And when the time comes, he's gonna canary her across the threshold. Now, what compares with that? Movie stars love birds. Just ask Walter Pigeon, Robin Williams, or Mia Sparrow. And they'll tell you that birds are really something to crow about. So get one for yourself, just for a lark. If you don't know much about them, just wing it. Because it's a finch, you can't go wrong. And always remember, a bird in a hand can be a mess. You remember that, and I love you and give you a big kiss. Yes?
I can't stand it anymore. My husband beats me. Beats me, I tell you. Morning, noon, and night, he beats me. I don't care so much for myself. It's the children I'm worried about.
The children?
Yeah, they beat me too.
Let's find out what the weather's going to be, Dad.
From Fellman Brothers International, don't miss The Monster Who Refused to Eat Cleveland. See the gigantic monster land in Cleveland during rush hour and be brutally mugged by two senior citizens using orthopedic slingshots. That's the monster who refused to eat Cleveland. Void where prohibited by law. Member FDIC and FDIC-FM.
And now, fellas and gals, here's that request you've all been waiting for. Smog along the Mexican border, or Jose, can you see?
Here's a news item with a happy ending. This morning, the Johnny Man Singers were kidnapped. But fortunately, the kidnappers released them just 1 hour later when they threatened to sing.
Now let's take a look at the weather forecast. Uh-huh. Yeah, okay. Uh-huh. Right. Looks okay to me.
Uh-oh.
Hey, it's the boo. Listen, what are you doing? This is the phone book. I didn't even know you had one.
Are you kidding? I've read it already.
You read the phone book?
Yeah, terrible plot, but what a cast.
What, was there any part in here that you especially like?
Well, to be fair about it, it starts off good.
Yeah?
On the first page, someone yells, I want a policeman, I want a fireman, I want an ambulance. After that, it sort of tapers off.
The next thing you're going to be telling me is that it's time for the Pookie Player.
Okay, it's time for the Pookie Players.
They're back, gang.
The front, too. Hit it, Dave.
Hey, gang, you're back. The Pookie Theater presents... The Pookie Player.
Yeah.
The Safari. Uh-huh. That old black magic has me. Oh.
Gotta set the stage.
Okay. Has Mrs. O'Brien. She feels fine, but the stork is dying.
When my government learns of this, I guarantee you, all of you will regret the day you ever saw me.
Me not afraid. Me, big chief. Chief of whole tribe here.
Yeah? Well, listen, Chief, I just happen to be with the London Daily News, and when my paper learns of this, you'll...
What is your job on this London Daily News?
Well, I happen to be the editor of the travel section.
You should be happy then, because tonight you will be editor-in-chief. Yum, yum, yum.
Well, that, Pook, that was just wonderful.
Thank you. Hey, Soup, yeah? I wonder if you could do me a favor.
Well, if I can, I sure will.
Okay, wait a minute.
All right. Wait a minute. Oh.
Now, I've had a little accident, you see, yep. And I can't write. I was hoping...
You know what? You're right. Okay. You want me to write?
Wait a minute.
I'd be happy to.
Well, I was hoping you could address this postcard for me.
Okay, go ahead.
Oh.
Yeah, what address is it to say?
Well, gosh, I really do appreciate it.
That's all right. Just tell me. That's all right.
Well, it's to Miss Sue Snyder.
Miss Sue Snyder.
2104 Lupino Lane.
2104 Lupino Lane.
Marymount, South Dakota.
Marymount, South Dakota.
8820.
Okay, there you go. Now, is there anything else that I can do for you?
Gee.
Yeah?
Yeah, you're nicest. There is one thing.
What's that?
Well, you see, I haven't actually written the message I want on the postcard, and I was sort of hoping that once I got somebody to write the address for me...
Say no more! I understand. What message would you like me to write?
I hope I get a chance to make this up to you, Sue.
That's all right. That's okay. Go right ahead.
Well, yeah. Would you write,
yeah.
Dear Sue, the doctor says everything is healing just fine, and I should be in good old shape real soon.
In good old shape real soon.
And would you sign it? Your Pookie.
Your Pookie.
Yeah.
Okay, there it is. Ricky, there you are. Glad to help you anytime.
Listen, I wonder if... Could I trouble you to write one more thing?
No trouble at all. What shall I write?
P.S. Please excuse the sloppy handwriting and lousy spelling.
Yes?
Mr. Sales.
Yes?
I heard you talking before about birds on your show, so I came right over. I wonder, would you like to make a donation to save the woodpeckers?
Well, I didn't know they were in trouble.
Oh, yes. All over the world, there are millions of needy little woodpeckers going hungry.
Oh, wow. Let me see what I can do.
Oh, you're a wonderful man, Mr. Sales. Wonderful.
How about these drumsticks? Them ought to make a good meal.
Actually, what I had in mind was a little bread.
A little bread? Yeah, man. How about...
No, that's paper. Woodpeckers don't eat paper, you dimwit.
Oh, I'm sorry. Just a second.
Look, will you hurry up? They're starving.
Oh, yeah. How about, I'll give you this.
Great.
Loaf of bread. Listen, could I have a receipt for my income taxes?
Sorry, I don't give any receipts.
Oh, this is for the birds. Listen, don't I get anything to prove that I gave?
Oh, yes, with every donation, I give you a free bird call.
Well, that's better than nothing, I guess.
Well, would you like to hear the call of the yellow-bellied fern knocker?
I never heard of the bellied fern knocker. Oh, where are they from?
Oh, they're found on the eastern shores of Madagascar, the western slopes of the Himalayas, and the sidewalks of New York.
Is that right?
Yes. Yes, they are the world's teeniest, tiniest little birds. Yeah. You can hardly notice them because their size is so small. However, they sound just like this.
Yeah. I thought you said it was a tiny little bird.
Yes, but it's all mouth. Incidentally, do you do any bird calls?
Oh, yeah, I do that. Listen to this. This is a Bob White.
Good.
This is a cardinal.
We should sure use Stan Musial.
This is a bluebird. This is a blue-tailed thrush.
Hey, wait a minute. They all sound the same.
Yeah, what do birds know? I'm going to fly out of here.
Yes, yes. This is Inspector Wilhelm of the Budapest Police. What's that? Three more bodies found last night. Little puncture marks on their necks. No blood. Jugular veins severed. Bodies mingled. What? What do I think? Must be the work of a prankster. I'll look into it. Goodbye. Oh, yes. There must be some connection between these murders and the strange sounds that have been reported from Shark Island. I've heard rumors that Count Dracula has been experimenting again. Two black marks on the throat. Sounds like a bunch of hogwash.
It's wonderful, wonderful. It's a great idea, freezing blood into the shape of a donut. I wonder if Birdseye knows about this.
Master, I got a great idea.
great one. Guess what this is?
What is that?
The 6 o'clock noose. Film at 11. What are you doing?
I'm working on a new experiment.
You're building another monster. You promised you'd operate on me and you'd get rid of this so I could be tall and straight like so. But you never did it.
Wait just a moment.
What? What are you doing, Master?
I'm just playing a hunch. What have you been doing?
Oh, nothing, Master.
Nothing, nothing.
What's that for?
That's for nothing. You should be out getting bodies for me. I'm going to have to punish you.
No, look, there's no more room.
I wonder how little Dracula is getting on.
Oh, Papa, Papa, it's so good to have the lid open.
Oh, shut up and drink your blood. Bye, Papa, good night. Oh, pig always bites more than he can chew. Yes? It's the second door to the left. He's been here 3 months. He still don't know where it is. All right. I want to know what... Shut up down there. It's all right.
I think it's from that way.
Oh, yes. Why do you always lock yourself in? Now to continue with my experiment. For 2 years, I've been working on this, and today I'm going to bring him to life.
I am Inspector Wilhelm of the Budapest Police. This is my assistant, Eduardo.
Permit me to introduce myself. I am Count Dracula. What can I do for you?
I am here to investigate some strange noises from your castle.
What kind of noises?
Bellowing sounds.
That's me. I have an upset stomach.
No, I mean weird muffled sounds.
I have a mute. What can I do for you? Huh? I know what I can do for you.
He's like shoofing a book like keeping a bakery.
What did he say?
I don't know. I don't trust you. I think you're a vampire.
Who's a vampire? You're trying to play me for a sucker? I told you before, leave me alone. Leave me to my experiments. Why must you meddle?
We're not taking any chances. I want you and your band of monsters to clear out of this village. You got 24 hours.
All right. Don't bug me. Split. Get out of here. But you can stay.
Mystery shoe, twy. It's better than the man he keeps again, though.
What did he say?
He thinks you talk funny.
How come you didn't know what he said before?
It wasn't important. Right, get out.
Is everything ready?
Ready, Master!
All right, Igor, tonight I complete the experiment! Oh, that's marvelous! All right, Igor, hand me the eyes!
The eyes!
Are they bloodshot?
Not anymore! Here's some more!
Yes, just one second! More eyes!
Now what?
Oh, let's see! The hair! Ah, oh, that's marvelous! The hair! All right,
careful.
Now the nose! Nose! The nose! Yes! Now the ears!
There's the left one!
The left one!
Here's another left. They were all out of right.
That's all right. He'll walk sideways. All right. Now the brains.
The brains.
The brains.
The brain. Careful.
Careful.
Ah, yes.
That's a good brain.
Oh, yeah. All right. Make the hold that while I make the incision.
Okay.
All right.
Give me that.
Watch it. Watch it. All right. Okay. All right, there. All right. That's the thing I get. Finally, it's finished.
It's finished.
Get up. Get up. Get up. Get up. Look. Look at that.
That's the worst one you've ever done.
The worst one?
The worst.
Hand me those. Hand me those.
What are you doing?
I'm tearing up the blueprints.
What shall we call him, Master?
Let me see. We already have Frankenstein, the fly, the mummy.
Yes.
The blob and Godzilla.
So what do we call him?
I got it.
What?
I got it.
What?
I will call you Wolfman.
Doesn't have to call me Wolfman. You can call me Jack. You can call me Matt. You can call me Zach. You can even call me back. But you doesn't have to call me Wolfman.
It's a big experiment. You go to California, you spin records.
Yes.
You use Olivia Newton's John.
Oh,
that's a success. Thank you so much for being with us. Have a wonderful evening. A great day tomorrow. Bye-bye, everybody.